Hey everybody, it's Roger, and this is the next video in our FAFSA walkthrough, and the section that we're going to be covering today is the school selection section. It's got two parts. First part is saying what school you graduated from, and the second part is what school you want to apply to potentially in the fall to go to college next year. So we're going to start off real quick. You put in the name of your high school in this first section. Then you tell what city that school is located in and what state. Scroll down to Washington, and we're off to the next section. Pretty simple. So this section is where you're actually going to pick the colleges that you want to apply to so that FAFSA can send them the information about your financial aid. And that's important because lots of times schools may have other financial aid available besides what the federal government provides. And so the only way that they know if you need that money or not is through getting this information about you or your household income. So it also lets the state know if you qualify for certain financial aid from the state. So you're going to want to make sure that you put on at least one state school onto this section. So you can add up to 10 schools. If you know the federal school code, you can say yes by clicking this button and there's an entry box. But if you don't know it, it's totally okay. Just click no, I don't know it. You select the state in which the school is in. You have to pick a state. So we're going to click Massachusetts, and then you have to have the school name. So we're going to put Harvard here, and then we're going to search. And it's going to pull up all the listings potentially for Harvard University. And here you're going to see there's multiple Harvards. Some state schools also have this if they have different locations, like UW Washington has Seattle location, but it also has Bothell location and others. But just pick the one you want. So we're going to go ahead and just pick this one. And we're going to say next. And then it's going to ask us this question. It's going to say, what is your housing plan for that school? So you basically have three options for picking a housing plan. Either on campus, means you're living on the university. You're going to be living with your parents, which means you may not need so much money. Or off campus, which means you're living on your own or with some other folks going to school locally. So for Harvard, we're going to pick on campus. And most schools that aren't going to be located real close to you, you're going to want to pick on campus. A lot of the state schools also require that you live on campus for the first year, although some of that's changing because of COVID. You still want to try to pick on campus because that means you need the most money possible. So that's a good way to look at it. Also here, you can view college information about that school. That's nice information to have. You can print that out or just close it. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to say we're going to add more schools, right, to our list. And then, so we're going to say we want to see all the schools in Washington State. So we click on Washington State and we don't put in a name and we say search. And it'll actually pull up, I think, 94 schools in the state of Washington. So you would go through and you would just pick the schools that you want. So there's Bellevue College, Central, DigiPen. You can just click it and it'll add all these schools. Let's see, Evergreen State, we'll put on there too. You go next, and it asks you about your housing situation. What's your housing plan? So Bellevue College, let's say you're living with your parents, or DigiPen, they don't have any on-campus housing, so you might most likely live off campus or with your folks. Evergreen State, on campus most likely if you're coming from the Seattle area. So you have to pick those. And then the other thing you can do is you can move these. You can remove it. In the state of Washington, you will need to have at least one state school on this list. That way the state government can see your needs as well through the FAFSA. So you can have up to 10 schools on this list, no more than 10. We suggest that you pick as many as you think you're going to apply to. Now you can change this list after you submit. I would wait till you get confirmation that your FAFSA has been finalized before you change this list, okay? That's super important. So you make this list, click the next button, and basically you move on to the next section. So that's it for me. Make sure you follow the link at the end of this video to the next section so you can get more help. Good luck in your pursuit of college, and let us know if you need anything.